Hey, what's up, guys? Been a little while, but I'm back with some more Yu-Gi-Oh nonsense. Let's see, I gotta update you on. Oh, I went to play Tacoma, the YCS there. I went 5-3, just barely didn't make the playoff cut using Evil Swarm. Had a good time though. One of the funnest times I've ever had playing Yu-Gi-Oh! This weekend, tomorrow, they're actually playing the OTS in Renton, but unfortunately I can't go because of work. I have to work tomorrow, which I don't know why. We're not behind, but I gotta go in and repair things. Why they needed to force me in when they had 3/4 of the crew volunteering, I don't know. Why do I have to go in? I don't get it. I'm not too happy about it, but whatever. That's another different problem. Anyways, I had to play Necros twice. I lost to him twice. Almost beat him both times with Evil Swarm. They're pretty good. I ain't gonna lie. Necros is probably one of the better decks to come out in the last couple years, but they're not unbeatable. I've seen worse. But yeah, I mean, if I had to go off top decks right now, number one would be Necros, two Cool Fort, three Burning Abyss, and then fourth, it's tough. I'll probably go with Shaddolls, and fifth to Teller Knights, and then six Evil Swarms. I think Evil Swarms is probably the best underrated deck in the game right now. But anyways, yeah. So anyways, what I got today, I went to Fred Meyer's again, local Fred Meyer's out in the woods, and kind of out in the woods, and they had 9 packs of the Secret Forces in blister packs, and I've generally been pretty good at blister packs at this Fred Meyer's so far. So I figured, why not try it out? See if I can't get a Necros, a Bryonic, Trishula, or Valkyris. Either one of those would be pretty awesome. Same with this guy, I don't even know his name, but I guess he's pretty sought after too. See how many Vanny's Emptiness I get out of this. It's amazing Vanny's Emptiness was a short print as a common in Star Strike Blast, and then in Legendary Collection 5 it was a super short print, but now here it is, like a regular rare basically. That's its rarity in this. Okay, so I guess going for the Trishula, or actually the Bryonic, that's what I want. See if I can't get it. See how many repeat cards I get too. Ritual Beast Tamer Elder is the secret. I have not played a Ritual Beast yet. I haven't at all. I guess they're good. That's what I've heard. People have said they've played them online and even at the store, but I have not seen one at all. I've seen quite a few Zuzenju. Those things are terrifying. The squirrels, or whatever they're supposed to be. Okay. There's Abyss Dweller. That's pretty cool. That is a reprint. Amazing how long it took them to get reprinted. Necroz Mirror. This is probably one of the better ones. Remember Armageddon Knight. Necroz Mirror. Kaleidoscope's the best one they have. I hate Kaleidoscope. Necroz Cycle. I mean, all three of them are annoying, but I think Kaleidoscope is by far the most annoying. I had a guy like use it, set like a shooting quasar dragon, shooting or whatever Stardust quasar dragon, whatever that thing's called, and was able to like ritual summon like two or three Necroz monsters. It was annoying. And another Ritual Beast Tamer Elder. That's two Necrogardener. There's two elders. Does anyone use it? I actually saw people using this card, Great Sorcerer of the Necroz. I've actually seen him used a couple times. So, that is a legit card, I guess. Is there any Necroz card I haven't seen used? I think I've even seen Dance Princess once. I don't know. It's confusing. Just so much. Just so much, you know? There's another Abyss Dweller. I've got two of those now. Necroz of Colossalis. Is the big bird one. This is a pretty annoying card when the evil swarms. Plus, I get a search. Perfect. I love the. I've mind crushed this a lot of times. My favorite one is Bryonic. I love mind crushing Bryonic. So good. They're like, Bryonic? I'm like, yeah, sure. And then boom. Ain't gonna happen. Whatever you picked up, that whatever it is, dead now. Preparation Rights, I think this is a card and the next ban list is going to get limited. I really do. I feel that Preparation Rights, if Necroz dominates again at the next regional, I really feel that Preparation Rights will be one of the cards they'll look at it hitting. Another Abyss Dweller. Wow, that's three. And Ritual Beast Tamer win. Getting a lot of Ritual Beast Tamers and a lot of Abyss Dwellers out of what? How many packs have I... Out of five packs, I've gotten three Abyss Dwellers. You know how stoked I would have been if that was the case with Abyss Rising? Like, holy crap, five packs and get three Abyss Dwellers? That'd be awesome. I don't know why they reprinted Altitude Knight. Is there something I'm missing? Like, they reprinted the Djinn monsters because rituals, and all the ritual, like Ritual Weapon, Ritual Cage, I get it. But Altitude Knight, where did this come from? Same with Necro Gardener. What is that all about? I guess they thought it was time. Another Preparation of Rites. Ritual Beast Ulti Cannahawk. How about that? I guess they're good, but I have not seen any of them, so obviously they're not that amazing yet. Nobody's unlocked the true power of Ritual Beast. Now these Yusenshus, I've played against them quite a few times, and I have yet to beat him. If the guy knows how to play Yu-Gi-Oh! Gishki Chain, remember when people really wanted Gishki Chain back in the day? Soul Release got reprinted. Don't know why. I think that's the first reprint of it since Metal Raiders, I want to say. I don't know if this card's ever been reprinted before. Probably wasn't Dark Beginning a long time ago, but I've only seen the Metal Raiders version. And a Necroz of Unicore. This is probably the most easy one to get, the Necroz monsters. It has pretty sweet armor. I like the unicorn on its shin guards. I think that's pretty awesome. So it's one that you see the most of. This is the one I saw the most of at YCS was unicorn. I got hit by a Trishula at the YCS, but it really didn't do that much damage to me. I mean, actually it did. It didn't hurt me with the banishing from the grave, of course. I mean, it's great. I mean, it just didn't. And then from the field, it didn't really bother me. But from the hand, it took my Mandragora. And I actually needed Evil Swarm Mandragora. And that sucked. But like I said, they were close games versus Necroz. I was surprised. As much hype as there was, I thought for sure I'd be demolished. But I stuck right in with them. Very close games. Ritual Weapon. I'm going to stick that in a Necroz deck. Gishki Shadow. There's a Vanity's Emptiness. Waiting for that one. And a Necroz Kaleidoscope. The most annoying Necroz card. Got one Vanities. That's what mattered. Okay. These Djinn monsters are so fat. There's another one. Royal Decree. People are using that in Necroz. That's like the only trap I ever see in Necroz. Spiritual Beast, Canhawk, and Ritual Beast Tamer win. Wow, Ritual Beast on parade here. So out of the nine packs, I guess the best card I got was Vanity's Emptiness. There really isn't anything good out of this hidden arsenal. That's how it usually is. There's usually like one or maybe three cards at the most that people want. Everything else is just garbage, value-wise. But yeah, I got the Vanity's, and that's good. So anyways, hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I did. I'm not enjoying going to work tomorrow. Nobody wants to get up at 3 a.m. on a Saturday and drive into a factory. I hope I do something tomorrow. I don't want to go there, and because I'm not even doing my normal job. I'm doing like fixing things, and you know, I don't know if I want that, because I don't want to go in there and just be like, wow, there's nothing for me to do right here. And then you know, whatever. Anyways, thanks for watching.